In other news, Chinese vessels once again rammed and fired water cannons at a Philippine ship conducting resupply mission in Escuela Shoal Sunday. The National Task Force for the West Philippine Sea says at least 8 Chinese vessels conducted dangerous maneuvers against the Fisheries Bureau's BRP Datu Sandai, which resulted in engine failure and early termination of the humanitarian operation. It also denied claims made by the Chinese side it rescued Philippine personnel who fell into the sea. The Philippine government again urges China to stop its provocation actions that pose danger to the safety of Filipino crew and fishermen. The latest incident comes just a week after 2 Philippine Coast Guard ships sustained damage after being hit by Chinese vessels near Escuela Shoal. The intensifying manhunt for fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. The Philippine National Police vowing no let up in the search despite sharp criticisms on their operation. The Davao chapter of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines has urged the police to uphold the rule of law and for Quiboloy and his co-accused to submit to legal processes. But PNP Chief Romel Francisco Marbil says the operation will continue until Quiboloy's arrest warrant is served.
Ito, guidance po natin, we have to follow human rights. Hindi po kami puapayag po yung sinasabi nyo na puputuloy yung kuryente, puputuloy po yung mga tubig. No, we follow human rights. Yun po yung guidance po natin. Then sa, with regard po dun sa location po ng tao na to, as long as hindi po namin nasiserve yung warrant, that's a warrant sa parets, and we are certain nandun po yung tao, then we have legal na pwede po kaming tumagal doon. Especially right now that we unearth more cases ng illegal human trafficking against these people, eh di lalo pag magkapatong-patong ang kaso nila.
Supporters of Quiboloy have gathered outside the KOJC compound in Davao to denounce the Marcos administration and force authorities to stop the search. They also claim police are merely acting on suspicions on the whereabouts of the pastor. But Marbil denies this.
Meron po kaming ano doon. Meron po kami mga tao na nagsasabi po na nandun po siya. It so happened that they are already prepared. Kaya nga sila naglagay ng barbed wire eh. Diba? Kasi kung wala naman doon tao, ba't ka maglalagay ng masyadong maraming barricades? Diba? Yan yung look, you know, tell us before and after na we implemented yung unang serving of warrant sa Parehas.
The Duterte clan calling on authorities to uphold human rights as the hunt for Quiboloy continues. In a statement, Vice President Sara Duterte said she vehemently condemns the gross abuse of police power in the takeover of the KOJC compound. She also said the police is betraying the trust of the Filipino people. Her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, also slammed the operation, claiming the Philippines has never been in a more tragic state as it is today. He also called on the Marcos administration to guarantee the preservation of constitutional rights of Filipinos. Meanwhile, Senator Ronald De La Rosa visited the KOJC compound as part of the Senate inquiry on the alleged excessive use of force in serving the arrest warrant against Quiboloy. He called on the pastor to surrender.
Yes, kasi meron naman warrant talaga galing sa korte. We cannot hide forever. So, at saka, kawawa na rin yung tao natin dito na nagsasakripisyo dahil sa kakahanap sa kanya. Yung lang naman sa akin.
The Commission on Human Rights, meanwhile, reminded both the police and KOJC members to follow the judicial process in the operation to locate Quiboloy. Philippine lawmakers vow no stone will be left unturned in their scrutiny of Sheila Go and Cassandra Ong. The two are set to be transferred to the custody of the House and the Senate, where they are facing arrest orders for snubbing POGO hearings. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian says they will dig deep to find the masterminds behind illegal POGOs, as well as government officials and businessmen aiding them. Meanwhile, House lawmaker Zaldy Co wants to investigate how the family of dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go and their companions left the country despite law enforcement agencies having huge secret funds. The two were arrested in Indonesia last week, where Alice Go is believed to have been hiding. Israel and Hezbollah engaged in one of their biggest clashes in more than 10 months of border warfare. Hezbollah launched hundreds of rockets and drones at Israel early on Sunday, while Israel's military said it struck Lebanon with around 100 jets to thwart a larger attack. Both sides have indicated they were happy to avoid further escalation for now, but warned there could be more to come. Any major spillover in the fighting risks morphing into a broader regional conflict, drawing in Hezbollah's backer, Iran, and Israel's main ally, the United States.
We are hitting Hezbollah with surprising thrusts. 3 weeks ago, we eliminated his chief of staff, and today, we foiled his offensive plan. Nasrallah in Beirut and Khamenei in Tehran should know that this is another step on the way to changing the situation in the north and returning our citizens safely to their homes. And I repeat, this is not the end of the story.
Expectations of an escalation had risen since a missile strike in the Golan Heights last month killed 12 youths and the assassination of a senior Hezbollah commander in response. Many travelers at Beirut's airport find themselves stranded following the latest escalation between Israel and Hezbollah. Jordan's flag carrier, Royal Jordanian, suspended flights to Beirut on Sunday. No exact time frame has been given for the suspension. Air France has canceled flights in and out of the Lebanese capital until at least Monday. Meanwhile, Israel's biggest municipalities shut down its Mediterranean beaches. Tel Aviv and Haifa city halls, as well as other coastal towns, announced the move after Israeli military told the public to limit gatherings. Authorities lifted the restrictions several hours later as the cross-border fire abated. A member of the Reuters team covering the war in Ukraine is killed in a strike on a hotel in the eastern city of Kramatorsk. Two others were injured. The fatality was identified as Ryan Evans, a former British soldier who had been working as a safety advisor with the agency since 2022. Reuters was not able to verify if the missile that hit the hotel was fired by Russia or if it was a deliberate strike on the building. The Russian Defense Ministry has not responded to a request for a comment. Ukraine has opened an investigation into the attack. Over in Thailand, at least 13 were killed following a landslide in Phuket. 19 more were injured, while hundreds of households were affected. The landslide was triggered by days of heavy rains. It occurred behind the Big Buddha, a popular tourist attraction in the area. A major cleanup is underway. A deadly landslide also hitting Indonesia. Authorities say at least 13 people were killed, while six more are still missing in Indonesia's North Maluku province. Floods hit the east of the country, damaging homes and burying people in mud. Indonesia's Disaster Management Agency urges locals to remain vigilant with more rains in the forecast. The ability to ignore your boss, which may be a fantasy for some, is now a reality in Australia. This, thanks to a right to disconnect law designed to curb the creep of emails and calls into personal life. The new law, which comes into force today, means employees cannot be punished for refusing to read or respond to contact from their employers outside work hours. Supporters say the law gives workers the confidence to stand up against the invasion of their personal life by work, a trend that's accelerated since the pandemic. The changes add Australia to a group of roughly two dozen countries which have similar laws, which was pioneered by France in 2017. Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Alzar Aurelio. Hi, Alzar.
Hello, Bettina. Today, southwest monsoon affecting most part of the country, so we expect rainy days today. The areas will be experience cloudy sky with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm are Visayas, Limaropa, Bicol region, Zamboanga Peninsula, Quezon, Basilan, Sulu, and Tawi-Tawi. Meanwhile, the rest of the country, including Metro Manila, will have generally fair weather, which is partly cloudy to cloudy skies. But we expect isolated rain showers or thunderstorm, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. As of today, there is no LPA or low pressure area or tropical cyclone inside the Philippine area of responsibility. That's our latest update from PAGASA. I am Alzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar.